Racing rivalry between New South Wales and Victoria is heating up this morning with Sydney to host a $2 million race on Melbourne Cup Day. Live to today's Sydney reporter Gabriel Boyle at Royal Randwick Racecourse. Gabby, it's an all-out turf war, this one.
It certainly is, Carl. Giddy up, Sydney v Melbourne. Peter Vallandis, of course, the mastermind behind Everest, the richest turf race in the world, has come up with this new idea. He's calling it the Big Dance. It would be held here at Royal Randwick, controversially, on Melbourne Cup Day. The race itself would run in the hours after Melbourne Cup. It would be half the distance and worth a whopping $2 million. That's heaps more money than most of the races that are held in Melbourne around the big race. The idea is effectively to steal the limelight from Melbourne, to attract a young crowd here, to make sure Randwick is absolutely pumping. It will be certainly very well received by the tourism and hospitality sectors here in New South Wales. The Spring Carnival is worth an absolute fortune to New South Wales tourism. It's going to be very interesting to see how this rivalry between the states plays out, Carl.
It is, Gabby. Thank you. Finally, a new turf war has erupted between Melbourne and Sydney. Racing boss Peter Vallandis launching an audacious attempt to steal the limelight from the race that stops the nation, planning a megabucks race at Sydney's Royal Randwick on the same day. Sarah, now I think the Cup Carnival in Melbourne has needed a facelift for years, but they've been going through a pandemic as well. Sponsorships, all that kind of thing's been hard. But will this help Melbourne get its act together?
Oh, no, I think you're being way too hard on Melbourne. I mean, the Spring Carnival in Melbourne remains an iconic day. The Melbourne Cup, it's a national institution. It's not their fault that they couldn't have capacity crowds at Flemington. It's still a great occasion. And, no, I think this is Melbourne's moment. And a lot of people travel from all across the country to be there. Look, you know, if you're in another state, if you're in Sydney and you want to go to an event, absolutely good luck to you. I'm not going to be the literal party pooper, but I think this is a real shame, and I'm just not going to buy into the interstate rivalry on this one.
Well, what do you mean? I mean that birdcage is tired. I mean, you can't drink your body weight in French champagne anymore. They've got this rubbish local drinks. I mean, it's just something to avoid completely.
I've never been there, Carl. I'll have to take your
word. Having been there a million times and looking to get invited to the next one.
I wouldn't be holding your breath for that invite this year.
Look, I do have a message from Peter Vallandis. He was going to come on today to talk about all this, but he is crook. I mean, he did send us this message to the Today Show. He said, I did a rapid test yesterday and it was negative. We'll do one now. Feels like a truck has hit me. It had Victorian number plates. How good's that, Matty?
Well, mate, I think my view is Sydney has enough. You get too much stuff already, and now you're trying to take another race. I think if we're going to have another race after Melbourne Cup, have it in Birdsville. That's the place to have a great race in this country. That's a great race meet. But Sydney, you've got enough as it is. You don't need more.
Good on you, Matty. Thank you. And Sarah, thank you. Racing New South Wales has ignited a turf war with Victoria, with plans to hold a $2 million race in Sydney on Melbourne Cup Day. Live to today, Sydney reporter Gabriel Boyle at Royal Randwick Racecourse. They may as well, Gabby, have the Melbourne Cup in Sydney.
Why not? No, I don't agree with that, Carl, really. I love a week-long trip to Melbourne to enjoy all of the festivities that go on down there. But this certainly is a pretty interesting, pretty controversial idea. The first Tuesday in November is usually when all eyes are on Melbourne for the race that stops the nation. But Peter Vallandis, the man behind Everest Race Day, wants another race held here. He wants to call it the Big Dance. It would be worth about $2 million. It would be run over half the distance, and it would take place in the hours after the Melbourne Cup, ensuring that Royal Randwick also gets to share in the spring racing carnival atmosphere and energy. It's certainly controversial, particularly when you talk to Melbourne punters.
Everyone wants to grab these big events. It's the same with the Grand Prix. Everyone wants a piece of the action, and I think Sydney wants a piece of the action, and I don't blame them.
Sydney is always trying to take Melbourne on, but I don't think anything will take away from the Melbourne Cup.
Carl, one group that absolutely would be in support of this would be the tourism and hospitality sector here in Sydney.
See how Melbourne responds. Gabby, thank you.